谢谢石先生。But to us, the open innovation concept or the ecosystem is more, we can make sense for high-tech companies. But for our Taiwanese companies here, the audience, we have a lot of service companies or OEM, ODM contractors. So how can we learn from this kind of ecosystems, no matter it's be more innovative or change their way to think about future. I know also in Singapore, the government has dominated the development, and I don't know if that can help the open ecosystem. To us, it's really hard to learn. If we are not a high-tech companies, we don't know how to learn it from the concept you just present, and even including Mr. Xu's just mentioned. So would you three probably highlight a little bit for our service companies or for OEM, ODM companies, how we can do?
Well, you mentioned Singapore, and you're absolutely right that the Singapore government is very involved, like a company, actually, to help with the ecosystems. So I think the concepts that Professor Russell presented are as relevant for understanding a company as it is for a government or government agencies for providing networks and contacts. So for example, the government could be establishing relationships for you. The government could be helping you with an entire eco-infrastructure of relationships. As you know, I'm currently based in Singapore, even though I normally teach at Columbia Business School. And at Singapore, I'm directing a new institute that is called the Institute on Asian Consumer Insight. And this institute is part of an ecosystem because the other parts of the ecosystem for understanding customers in innovative ways are, for example, agencies, research agencies, design agencies, branding agencies, of course also the consulting firms, of course the companies that are doing work on consumers, they're all part of an ecosystem. And that is all being set up by the government, because the government gives incentives to companies, to agencies, to design firms, to come to Singapore and create that ecosystem. And then the Singaporean companies, as well as international companies, can actually plug into that ecosystem. So I do believe the concepts just apply there as well. Now in terms of service businesses in Taiwan, I'm of course not so much of an expert, maybe Stan Chi can more comment on it. But I do believe that the concepts are very general, that they do not just apply to the high-tech business.
Just stop and speak in English, maybe easier for all of us. I think the service industry, we should consider to adopt this approach. And I hope the CCC can play a role on that. I believe all the service industry, including the manufacturer, try to bring the quality of the life. And the CC is talking about Chinese value system, lifestyle, and quality of life. And then if we have this as a common goal, the only way is through the cooperation of all members in different industry, share the experience together, and then they don't have a conflict interest, then they can come out a new idea to improve our quality of the life. And especially, we are trying to bring in a new competence that's lack in Taiwan, because customer insight study, innovation by the customer insight in the past is not very popular here. And this is the new driving force for the Taiwanese company to welcome the future of the Greater China market. That will become the biggest market, bigger than states. And market is driving force for the innovation, but how to innovation, we should learn from the states because they have a very good experience, good practice, and we should learn from what they practice and try to apply to improve the Chinese quality of life. And later on, we also can contribute to this to the global society.
I think there are a couple of perspectives that seem contradictory, but actually are synergistic that one can keep in mind. And on one hand, it's the long-term vision, and it's the way that you imagine the future. On the other hand, it's what we have to do today to survive, to be profitable. And to keep both of those perspectives in mind requires flexibility and agility, and requires a skill in being able to receive a new partner for a specific objective, and to gracefully let go after that objective has been met when it's necessary to take a different new partner in order to meet the next objective. Some people liken it to the skills that you would exercise when you go to a dance. You ask someone to dance for one song. At the end of that song, you return them to the position. In the next song, you ask another person to dance. The skills in taking partners and letting go of partners are an important part of the flexibility and the agility that an ecosystem will have.
I'd like to add to what Stan was just saying about the Chinese market being the biggest market in the future, and that therefore, as at CCC, we are really trying to understand the Chinese consumer. So help Taiwanese companies to capitalize on this huge opportunity. And Stan was saying, on the other hand, in terms of innovation, there's a lot to be learned from the US companies and US markets. I very much agree with that, especially when it comes to the technical innovation and broader-based ecosystem as is provided at Stanford is of course something that is worth copying and imitating and setting up also in a different context in other places in the world, and I believe that's actually happening. However, when you're looking at innovation beyond technical innovation, when you're looking at other aspects of innovation, it seems to me that we can also already learn something from some companies here in Asia. I was very interested in an article that was recently published in the magazine The Economist, where they were asking the question whether Alibaba will be the most valuable company within the next 5 to 10 years. Now that seems like a crazy question to ask right now when Apple is the major company. But when you're thinking about it, Alibaba is very, very much at the core of what Martha Russell described to us as relationships and as identifying the right partners and the right suppliers. That is really the essence of their B2B business. And as you know, nowadays they're also, of course, expanding into consumer businesses, so they will have a huge opportunity with the consumer markets as well. And what I think is interesting there is that there is no US company that has anything like that. And if Alibaba is able to further grow its business with Chinese consumers, to go abroad into other markets, then they are in a way providing a kind of model that is also worth taking a close look at. And that may actually be the value that The Economist is talking about in terms of saying they may very well be the most valuable company within a few years. So I do think the benchmarks of innovation can come from lots of different places and even from unexpected places, such as a company from China that is not even, I think, 15 years old.